suspicion. MRI brain tumor, mild diffuse cerebellar atrophy. All the other tests were normal. This is her MRI. You can see the cerebellum is almost atrophic, nothing. Atrophic cerebellum. Here also you see, usually the number of foliae, we don't count in MRI, we count it only in CT. MRI will be like this only. But definitely in the, on the coronal section, you can see the atrophic cerebellum. Next. Quickly finishing it, neurological difference, like most of the inherited disorders you can think of, like metachromatic leukodystrophy, neuroaxonal dystrophy, Niemann-Pick's disease, GM gangliosis, neuron lipofuscinosis, A-beta lipoproteinemia, Friedreich's ataxia. All these cases very difficult to diagnose, very rare also. But clinically we find telangiectasia and cerebellar, I'm sure it is diagnostic. Next. Dermatologically you can see the telangiectasia, which is a commonly seen condition, you know, the dilated capillaries in old people if you see, especially people who are working in Hudson all the time, farmers, laborers. They will have this facial telangiectasia, so age, sun exposure, all values. Then Rendu-Oxler-Weber syndrome, hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia, spider angioma due to liver failure, cutis marmorata telangiectasia congenita, hence another disorder, Bloom syndrome, like that Sturge-Weber, lot of inherited disorders which will have telangiectasia. Next. So the common complications, severe pulmonary infections, progressive movement disorders, confined, they become confined to wheelchair, malignancy, especially lymphoma, diabetes, progressive scoliosis and kyphosis. Next one. Management, we have no treatment to offer. Supportive treatment, prophylaxis for infections, sometimes neuroprotective, they may help, calcium channel blockers and antioxidants. Screening for malignancy is a must. Yeah. Prognosis, early death, commonly early adolescence due to respiratory infections. In this case, she was coming every 6 months or something, she never had any problems. Suddenly, father rang up and said she is not able to walk. She has difficulty. It is not the usual difficulty, more than the usual difficulty. I don't have the video on the MRI. I think this place somewhere. I was searching for 24 hours. I couldn't get. Maybe in some other time I'll show you. And then she developed right hemiparesis. She was brought to the. I thought sudden onset, probably it's a vascular event. So I did a MRI, repeat MRI. That showed a huge phase of brain, probably lymphoma, primary lymphoma. There are two things in brain, primary lymphoma and secondary lymphoma. Primary lymphoma comes from the brain, secondary is they have other somewhere else. So we were planning for a stereotactic biopsy on Monday, but she succumbed to that huge big tumor on Sunday. So we lost her, probably due to huge big primary lymphoma of the brain. So precautions. We'll avoid unnecessary X-rays and avoid radiation for these children. Genetic counseling is important, especially for parents, because they have a slight increased risk of cancer. Even though they do not have the features of telangiectasia, they may be more prone to get cancer. So it is better to screen the parents for cancer regularly. Next. Thank you very much. I think I am not taking much. 1 in 40,000 to 1 in 100,000. I have seen only one case. Professor Patrick, when I talked to him about this case, he was feeling down to his ear. He has only 2 cases in his 50 years, 60 years of practice. Very rare. Because, you know, it's genetic. This child has no family history. But they say it's autosomal recessive. They identify the gene as the ATM gene.